evening. I'm Kathleen Parker.
And I'm Eliot Spitzer. Welcome to Parker Spitzer. Tonight, we discuss the single most important issue framing these midterm elections. What role should government play in getting us out of this recession? And let's face it, there are two fundamentally different views of that. One, the Tea Party Republican view, which says government should do less, and the Democratic view, which says government has got to do more.
A new movie opens tonight. It's called I Want Your Money, and it's a conservative argument for dramatic cuts in spending. The film being released just 2 weeks before the midterm election. Any way you look at it, it's a political statement. Let's take a quick look at a clip from the film. What I'm mostly concerned about.
Yeah. Is and the answer to your question is no, but that's all right.
The left has its films, the right has their films, and everybody, to me, it's a political coagulant, and I worry that we will simply harden our views as we go along. This film is, you know, we know that there's some historical inaccuracies in it, but it speaks to the people who want to believe this particular message, and I am philosophically more attuned with the conservative view than the liberal view when it comes to these things, but I get turned off very quickly when I hear words put into someone's mouth that were not true.
That's right. For instance, this movie calls President Obama a socialist, and I think
socialism is good.
But here's what bothers me, and I know you make fun of the way I love numbers. The reason I love numbers is because they're facts, and I think if you drill down to facts in a real, it isn't quite as simple as big government, little government. It's a government that believes in markets.
Now let's get to our headliner segment, that right-wing film we've been talking about, I Want Your Money. The director, Ray Griggs, stopped by for a special screening with us, and I tried unsuccessfully to get Eliot to be nice to him. Fair warning.
Joining us now for a headliner interview, the filmmaker of I Want Your Money, Ray Griggs. Thanks for coming in.
Ray, thanks for having me.
Ray, congratulations on your release today. For a minute, just describe what the movie is, for those who don't know about it yet.
Basically, my film is Reaganomics versus Obamanomics. And basically, it contrasts the two roads we can go down. One is this current administration, or trying to go back to the conservative values and beliefs of that of Ronald Reagan.
And just so it's clear, the release was timed to come out right now before the election so you could have sort of make a political statement.
Absolutely. I wanted to give people proper tools to take with them on November 2nd so they make wise decisions on what course to take.
Now, you have made this film outside the usual Hollywood movie system. In other words, you've self-financed, is that right?
Right. I self-financed the production end of it, where I got private investors for the P&A, going through self-distribution. Because, you know, naturally a studio wouldn't pick this up just because of the concerns of the liberal left in Hollywood. You know, and it was
a tough road. And lots of money being spent on advertising just this week, so you've obviously gotten some funding help from other sources.
Right, that's the independent financiers for the P&A, which is prints and advertising. But again,
Can you tell us who any of those are?
No, I'm not into that.
Is that available anywhere? I mean, would we see it in the film credits? No.
No. You know, just because of the plural nature of it, because a lot of people think, oh, well, they're political activists and all this, and it's not that. It's just...
Well, but they may well be political activists, but if you stand by the content of the film, that shouldn't really matter, right? If it's laid out in a way that seems factual and credible, then I would think people would be proud to put their names on it.
Well, yeah, I know.
One of the things, when we called you earlier, because we saw the movie was coming out, there'd been some articles, we are intrigued because it kind of stands in opposition by design to some of the other movies that have been out there that take a very different political perspective. So we called you for a copy of it, and you sent back an interesting email, which, and we appreciate your being here, but the email said, I don't have my glasses on, but it said, I did, however, provide you with video clips, but before that you said, I am not releasing screeners of my film to any film critics or network stations that generally promote a liberal view.
Correct.
So do you kind of view us as being the liberal media? I mean, we think we're fair and open to all perspectives, but...
Well, we'll see how this interview pans out.
Fair point, but we just want you to be here to explain.
Well, and that's why I decided to give you the benefit of the doubt and be fair.
Appreciate that.
I want to show people, okay, you know what? Let's cross the line.
Who do you put, I'm just out of curiosity, who do you put in that sort of liberal worldview category other than us, I suppose?
Every station out there, you got ABC, NBC, they've given, you know, Obama this they don't hold him accountable.
Can we come back to the movie? Give us in one sentence, what is the ideological statement you want the viewer to have at the end of this movie?
I would like people to go back to the conservative values and beliefs that Ronald Reagan had.
And by that you mean, theoretically, lower taxes and control of spending?
Control of spending and smaller government.
Can I come at it from just a slightly different perspectives. I saw in an interview you did that you said that 62% of the public doesn't pay taxes. Is that, am I correct in that's what you said?
Right.
You know that's
and
totally wrong.
Okay, why is that?
Well, because the vast majority of people, I'd say about 95% of people pay taxes. They pay sales taxes, they pay payroll taxes. They pay all the taxes that you incur every day. When people work, there are withholding taxes to pay for the Social Security system. Now, the income tax, which is only one of the many, many taxes we pay, is marginally progressive, but everybody pays the other taxes.
Right, but I was actually talking about the income tax.
Well, that's not what you said, and it's a huge difference, because if you look at the tax burden, what you'll see is the people who are right in the middle pay about, you know, we've got the numbers here, people who are right in the middle, the average person will pay about, you know, 14% of all of his or her income in taxes,
right?
Federal taxes, that ignores the states. And the people at the very, very top only pay 24%. So the people in the middle are paying 14, people at the top 24, people one notch lower about 7.5. So that's, you know, some progressivity, but not a whole lot.
Okay.
Right?
Where did you get this?
This is, I'm happy to share it, the Brookings Institute. I mean, these are numbers from the IRS and all the others. I mean, these are very...
Eliot. Did you bring your charts and graphs here today?
No.
I didn't think you did. Can we talk about the movie and the politics?
Sure.
I know you wanted...
I'm not an economist. I mean, there's plenty of people you can get on besides
you
me
to talk
about.
You can find a gazillion people who agree that, you know... That
I'm just trying to make an entertaining film.
People who work hard, don't want to hand over all their money to the government, that will then redistribute it to other people. I mean,
wait a minute.
But if you're a good capitalist, you agree with that. Come on.
No, I'm a capitalist. I'm not a foolish libertarian. And what I would say is that if you're distributing a movie to 500 cinemas in which you call the president socialist, you'd better have a foundation for that, wouldn't you think?
Okay. You said you're a capitalist?
Oh, yeah.
So but then why are you for, you know, government getting bigger and bigger and being intrusive?
I'm for government that ensures the competition works. And unlike President Reagan and President Bush, who made deals with the big banks to permit them, to permit the very, very rich, to take money from the hardworking middle class, we believe...
And Clinton.
But to a certain extent, but not nearly as much as the others, we believe that markets have to work, which means competition, which means, to be technical, competition law or antitrust law, which President Reagan and both President Bush's tried to destroy. So the real capitalists are the ones who believe in competition and markets, not the sort of gamesmanship that President Bush perpetrated. So I think before you call the president the socialist and send this movie out to 500 movie theaters with a movie whose funders you won't disclose to us, you should tell us what your foundation is for that.
Okay, well, let's forget history, okay?
No, what do you mean let's forget history? You can't forget history. I'm sorry, Ray,
just for a minute, because I want to talk about what's currently going on right now, because that's the real issue at hand. I mean, we could debate and get analysts and try to figure out how we got to this point. But the point is, today, okay, do you feel this current administration, okay, is doing a good job?
Well, I will say this. I think they've been much too cozy with Wall Street. I think that the reality is the stimulus needed to be bigger, not smaller. Business is sitting on $1.8 trillion of cash that it is not investing because there's no demand. And the lack of demand is precisely what FDR had to confront in the Depression. And the answer to that, and this is standard Keynesian economics, and it works, is you create demand by getting people to spend, either through a tax cut or direct government spending. This is Econ 101 that is appreciated by everybody from Alan Greenspan to Larry Summers. And so the answer is you create demand, and that's what the Obama administration is trying to do, because the Bush administration ran us over a cliff.
Well, and Ray, you actually agree with that, correct?
I mean, no, I do. And there's a lot there that we agree. I see what we are in similar terms, but just how we get there. I do believe in smaller government. I do believe in creating demand, and I do believe in capitalism, pursuing the American dream. But I believe in a smaller government, not interfering into our business and our lives, telling us how much we can make and everything else.
Well, I read somewhere that in some cities, in some communities, people have bought entire theaters full of seats for your film.
San Diego, Kansas City, Texas, there's people already that went in and just bought entire seats of the theater to, I guess, you know, give out tickets or, you know, whatever the situation is. So there's a growing response from it. You know, the amazing thing, now we can talk about the film, the amazing thing about the film, I mean, we have 3.5 million hits on YouTube. Mm-hmm. You look up Inside Job or any of these other, you know, documentaries out there, Fahrenheit 9/11, you know, they don't have that massive number of YouTube hits. So there's a crying demand out there from the middle to, there's an interest, it sparks an interest.
I applaud you for making the movie. I think it is what all citizens should do to participate. It's gonna be creative, it's fun, based on the part we saw, and wish you nothing but the best success.
How does it end?
Basically, I tell the people, you know, that we have to make a serious difference in November and make a sound decision and choose wisely and make sure that if you choose, you know, a Republican to get in office, that they have the same conservative values and belief as Ronald Reagan.
So you're a good sport, Ray. Thanks so much.
Thanks so much for coming in, and best of luck.
We really mean it. Thank you so much.
We'll be right back.
Stay right there.